I joined CTA 15 years ago, and my colleagues who were there were already working on digital solutions. I think CTA was one of the first development agencies working, sharing information using CD-ROMs. They were already talking about RSS. They were talking about social media the term social media was not used at that time, but anyway, electronic communication for sharing and gathering information. And so CTA has been at the forefront of that, at the forefront of innovation. And now we are looking at very advanced technologies, including drone technologies, including blockchains, including 3D printing, and so on. Always in the domain and support of the agricultural sector. 4 years ago, we had a strategy review workshop at CTA, and we were looking for innovations which we could start dealing with. And one technology which was put on the table was drone technology. At that time, really, it was at the very beginning of drone technology applied in the domain of agriculture. First operators we got in touch with were mainly traditional, partners CTA had been working with in the past in the domains of ICTs. So we offered them the opportunity to start engaging with the technology. This was in 2017, early 2017. So it was really new in Africa. We learned in the process. In 2017, we had two rounds of acquisition of partner organizations. The second round was through a call, and then we launched another call, Africa-wide call, in 2018, and we had quite a good response. We acquired other 16 partner organizations. We learned in the process, for example, data analysis initially was recommended to do it in the cloud, but limited internet access and the huge volume of data which needs to be transferred for analyzing multispectral images discouraged us from going for the cloud solution, especially when it comes to countries where access to the internet is limited and very costly. So in 2018, we offered a solution to our new partners to acquire in a co-funding scheme both hardware and software for processing images. So and then we provided quite extensive training on how to use drones to capture and to analyze images, and lately also on how to fly drones and to program missions and so on. So now the operators are quite conversant with the technology. What the big challenge now is the market. The technology is new. There is little evidence of cost and benefit, so we have some research projects which are looking into that. There is no doubt that for large to medium scale farms, the technology is generating benefits. The challenge is whether that applies also to small scale farmers. So one lesson we learned is that the technology is best used in the agricultural domain with small-scale farmers growing the same crop in contiguous areas, because you can't deploy an operator to fly a drone on a farm which is 1 hectare wide. So you have to have the opportunity to fly a certain area to justify the cost of the mission, of the displacement, and so on and so forth. So there are many opportunities, not only in the domain of crop production, but also livestock, environment, marine, coastal. There are a lot of opportunities. One has to be creative. What is important for the operators is to have a solid knowledge of the regulations, in terms of aviation. And now there is a new dimension which is sprouting in the domain of drone use. It's drones for spraying crops. And there you have another hazard, which are the collateral effects of spraying. And there another body of knowledge has to be developed on how to conduct this kind of operation. What are the conditions, for example, wind and drifting and all these kind of things, which needs to be taken care of. So, but the market is there. Marketers are predicting a huge development of the market of this kind of services. Let's see. I think that drone technology will help transform agricultural production in developing countries very fast.